One of my biggest pet peeves is the shut up and dribble, or shut up and play football, stick to sports. I've always heard that. And I'm sure Kilt's heard that, and anybody who speaks out for what they believe. That demonstration coming to Charlottesville woke me up even more to it. Because for a second, I had to fight the urge to be like, I feel bad for myself as a Charlottesville resident, as a white guy living in Charlottesville. I don't feel bad for myself as a Charlottesville resident. What I was so ashamed of was that I'm not this angry all the time when I realize that there's this ugliness in pockets in our country. And so, yeah, I mean, maybe it's a wake-up call. Even people that think they're awake to this stuff need when it happens in your hometown. And I was just frankly disgusted. I was so angry. I could never understand what it's like to be black in America, but for that moment, I was very upset. Like, beyond just being a white guy who hates racism and hates that ugliness, it's catapulted me into wanting to dive even further into, you know, fighting for social justice as a white dude from Charlottesville, living in America. It didn't teach me anything new. I knew it existed, but it heightened that for me.
We have to talk to our son about if he's ever stopped by the police, you know, keep your hands on the steering wheel, don't make any sudden moves, make sure you obey every order. You know, so those are very real conversations that we have to have with our 13-year-old son that I think is maybe different. You know, so we just come from different places, and so I think it's good for our students, our student athletes, our children to be informed. They also have to understand that there are sometimes consequences. And then the students, because they are informed, can make decisions. Well, I do want to speak out. You know, I do want to say something. Or I'll wait. You know, or it may not be safe for me. I may not feel safe in saying something.
What can I do? Like, I can say these things, and they're important because I play a sport, but the ball stops bouncing. It's going to stop for Chris, it's going to stop for me. And when that day comes, like, how do I present this message? How do I get these things that I know to be true out? It's really important that your hands are touching people, because sports will always give you that avenue also. So to talk about things, to talk in a locker room, yeah, it's important. Like, you have these tough conversations, but every time I'm in a locker room, I'm always like, I'm pushing guys, like, what can we do about it? What can we do about this?